Hello, Aloy.
Hey, Gaia. So, me and Beta, I guess you heard what happened.
Yes. I am continuously impressed by the complexity of human relationships. Despite the unpleasant circumstances that led to your quarrel, I am pleased to see you have both found an agreeable resolution.
Well, two heads are better than one, right?
Yes, I believe so. Are you ready to depart for Cauldron Gemini? Or we can continue our conversation, if you like.
So this facility, the Regional Control Center, it was meant to oversee the terraforming system?
For the local region? Yes. Had humans received their education from the Apollo database, they would have then been guided here to assume operation. As that never happened, this place remained vacant.
Until Minerva decided to settle here. Okay, people. It's time to head out.
I'll get everyone together.
Connections in place. Booting up.
Beta, Aloy. I am fully installed on this core and ready to connect to the Cauldron network.
It's good to hear your voice. Errant, everyone. Fire your pulses and sound off.
I'm at my cauldron. This thingy, it's blinking. Did I do it right?
In position at my cauldron. My pulse generator is blinking also.
That means they're working. I'm in position and mine is too.
Mine as well.
Okay, radio silence until I give the all clear. Signing off. Gaia, let's cage the beast.
Connecting to the cauldron network now.
Elizabeth Sobek, Alpha Prime, activating Omega Clearance. Elizabeth Sobek, Alpha Prime, activating Omega Clearance.
Clearance confirmed. Initiating containment sequence. Attempting to compensate.
It's cracked.
Look!
That means machines are on their way. Get ready!
Here they come!
Foral, stay here. Protect Beta.
Got it.
Be careful!
Where the sacred land!
Away for later. Force it out of wherever it's hiding. Make it retreat to the core. No, you don't, Hephaestus! I'll find another way over.
Aloy, I'm patched into your focus feet. You should know there's a huge power draw coming from the next chamber.
Thanks for the heads up. I'm almost there. It's some kind of production chamber. Hephaestus is up to something, all right?
What kind of machine is it trying to build?
I don't know, but I'm gonna shut it down. I bet those metal carriers further than it's where it's getting materials from.
I bet that's where Hephaestus is hiding, too.
Looks like there are a couple of ways I could go. Machines are moving away from the chamber. I better follow.
Aloy, I've managed to rewire most of the components in the core, but the energy processor's cracked. Without a way to fabricate another, there's no way I can fix it.
Okay, let me think. What if you bypass the processor. Connect it to
the power node. I think that could work.
I think it could. I should be able to catch a ride on one of those metal carriers.
Thank you.
To another chamber.
Well, I better not get comfortable.
Energy containment phase 6 over.
Great. HEPHAESTUS covered the floor with lightning. I gotta find a way over it.
Aloy! More machines keep coming! Please tell me you're getting close!
I'm working on it. I've been smashing through a lot of machines on my side, too.
I guess Aaron's missing out!
Anyway, I'm making progress on the bypass, but I need something to hold the sight link module together.
Maybe a ligament from one of the machine carcasses?
Right. Or some luminous braiding.
You could reinforce it with a conversion cylinder.
For increased connectivity! I think we can do this, Aloy.
Go again.
This doesn't sound good. I'll try to get your access back.
Finished it.
It's powerful, whatever it is. I'm almost done with the core repairs. Should we come to you? Maybe I could distract the machine if...
No. Or just stay where you are, okay? Handling the machine's my job.
Deploying priority unit S-Mark 1.
Huntress. Based on its legs and look, I think it's charging up. I could take out its tail, stop some of its attacks.
Sending HEPHAESTUS back to you.
No more hiding, HEPHAESTUS!
Ready for anything, though.
Got it! HEPHAESTUS is back in the core!
Make sure it stays there. I'm heading back.
And then we can start the merge.
Because of you, Beta. I'm glad you came along. And you, Varl. We couldn't have done any of this without you.
Right back at you, Aloy.
Bypasses. The core is stable. HEPHAESTUS is 100% contained. And we better get started with the merge. It's all set up. Gaia, establish the link, please.
Done.
We need to excise HEPHAESTUS' malicious code. Carefully.
Cost us quite a lot of time. Eric, get Beta. And squash that bug while you're at it.
Behind me.
Come on! Quit screwing around!
Now we're having fun, right?
Zelda, get Gaia and HEPHAESTUS ready for transport. Zelda!
I failed.
Hush. All is not lost.
Zelda! What the hell are you doing? Stop her!
Beta. Where am I?
Ah, you're awake. You took quite a hit when Gerard attacked you. I imagine you must still be in a great deal of pain. I can assure you that we are safe. The others can't detect us here.
You mean the other Zeniths? You must be Tilda.
I wasn't sure if Beta would have told you about me.
Where is she?
Alive. And while she isn't where she wants to be, not in urgent danger. We must discuss how to get her back, of course, after you've shaken off the cobwebs. When you're ready, take the stairs down the hall and come see me. In the meantime, I'll make breakfast.
Breakfast? Okay.
Just a few favorites from my collection. Rescued and stored here just before I went off-world. Take a look, if you like. I'm curious to hear your impressions.
My friend is dead. Beta and Gaia are gone, and you want me to look at old paintings?
Don't be so quick to dismiss the comfort we can find in art, or the insight we might gain. Stunning, isn't it? Paintings were the only masterpieces of my people's golden age. This is Von Vianen's done so soon?
I've got more important things to worry about.
We both do. There is much we are trying to save. Not the least of which is in that vault. There's nothing wrong with savoring such treasures for a moment.
There you are. Feeling better?
How did you find us? At the cauldron? And what did you do to everyone right before I passed out?
All business, I see. Well, suffice it to say we were keeping a very close eye on Hephaestus, knowing we would need it at some point. Your ruse didn't fool us, and as for my little trick, it was an overload of the senses. Accompanied by an energy discharge. Gerard and Eric were only momentarily disoriented due to their shields, but it rendered you unconscious while I got you out. Perhaps some breakfast might steady you a bit?
This was your house. The one you recreated for Beta, in the data channel you shared.
How perceptive of you. Please, this way.
After everything your people have done, you think I'm just gonna sit down and have a chat with you?
They're not my people. They never were, and especially not now.
You shot off into space with them. And live with them for 1,000 years before coming back. So what made you suddenly turn on them?
Quite simply, this.
My old focus. You repaired it? But that means you've seen
incredible things. What you've accomplished in 2 decades of life. Thousand years at my back, and I haven't even come close. I'm sorry if I invaded your privacy, but I had to. In order to understand, to be enlightened. You truly are Elizabeth's blood. With her drive, her sense of mission, her integrity. Watching all this shamed me for the company that I've kept. Having seen it, all I want is to help you.
Even if it means stopping your friends?
Especially so. Please, sit down. There. That's better. Now, we must recover Beta and Gaia at all costs. By now, you must know that Gerard intends to use Gaia to reboot the Earth's biosphere. Remaking this world to specifications that would only suit us immortals. This process will kill every living thing on the planet. He calls it a clean install.
Not if I stop him first.
Not if we do. And once he and the others are gone, we can work together to fulfill Elizabeth's dream. I'm sure Beta told you that there's a build of the Apollo database on board our ship. A complete collection of human knowledge. With that and Gaia, we could do everything Elizabeth wanted. Heal the biosphere, educate the people of this world, uplift them. Create the world she imagined.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. From what I've seen, your friends are invincible.
I do wish you would stop calling them my friends. And they're not invincible. In fact, a friend of yours has found a way to defeat them.
Silence.
Oh, he's been a busy bee, building an army powerful enough to crash through Gerard's precious base.
Regala and her rebels.
Even now, she's preparing a final march on the Tanakh capital. When she wins, she'll have the entire tribe under her control. Hundreds of warriors and machines to throw at the base. She's been duped. They'll all perish, of course. But it should be enough to break Gerard's defenses and allow Silence to kill him. Along with all the others.
Using the new weapon he's developed.
Yes, he's found a way to circumvent our shields. Truly an exceptional man. He's planned for everything. Except you and me. You see, while his army is battering down Gerard's doors, you and I will sneak in through a back way, one that only I know about, while Silence and my friends are busy battling each other. We'll take back Beta and Gaia. I told you I want to help you. I mean it.
My old focus. How did you find it, let alone repair it?
When we encountered you at the Hades Proving Lab, Gerard saw you as a redundancy. I knew better. You were a revelation. After your dramatic escape, bravo, by the way, Gerard and Eric assumed you were dead and gave up the hunt. I wasn't so sure. When the others were busy, I returned to the lab and searched for any trace of you. That's when I found this little treasure. Not easy to repair, but certainly worth the effort. As I watched your life unfold, you were like a splash of color on a worn canvas. What Liz was, and more.
Did you show it to the others?
Of course not. It was your actions that inspired me to defy them. It's worth noting that if I hadn't found it and watched its contents, I wouldn't have known to save you at the cauldron. You'd be dead.
So I should be grateful?
If you like.
So you know all about me? What about you?
What would you like to know?
Well, Start with your life on Earth.
When I was 8, terrorists flooded my home city. Thousands drowned, my parents included. I was one of the few who survived. My guardian sent me to boarding school. Among my peers, I was the strange girl, the orphan to be avoided. All because of circumstances beyond my control.
Oh. So we're a lot alike, huh?
Aren't we? You were an outcast. But you didn't let that stop you from getting what you needed. Neither did I. I climbed my way out of desolation and used my wits to build a fortune. First, from the technical analysis of art and the detection of forgeries. Profitable expertise in those days. But as it turned out, the software I developed was even more useful for counterintelligence. From there, it was only a short step to gathering extremely valuable intelligence on my own.
You were a spy?
More like a service one could turn to for information. I had to remain anonymous, of course, to protect my privacy. But despite that anonymity, Far Zenith inevitably sought me out.
What happened when Far Zenith approached you?
They painted an irresistible vision of humanity's future. One where we need not fear illness or death, where we explored the furthest reaches of the stars and thrived. It was only later that I realized that they only intended to bequeath this future to the rich and powerful. At the time I finally figured it out, the walls were closing in, Faro's machines were devouring the Earth. So I accepted Far Zenith's invitation to a birth on the Odyssey. I wanted Liz to come, but she had nobler plans, as you well know.
So you didn't know the other Zeniths were monsters until it was too late?
I knew some of them were, certainly. It wasn't until we were off-planet that I understood the true scope of their greed. I was grateful to simply be alive, but the others became obsessed with a kind of effortless immortality. They built a colony where machines serviced their every need, where any memory or fantasy could be endlessly savored in virtual reality. It wasn't life. It was stultifying. A pampered dream state. As the decades passed, I withdrew more and more, alone yet again. But this time with eons to consider my mistakes. Now finally, having met you, I feel like I have a second chance.
To do what?
Help you, of course. To fulfill Liz's dream, which isn't so different from Far Zenith's original vision. A better future for humanity.
You said Beta is not in urgent danger, so what are the Zeniths doing to her?
Putting her to work. Merging Hephaestus with Gaia. A difficult, time-consuming task, as I'm sure you know. They will compel her if need be, but her life is not in danger. She's the only one who can do it.
Because you people made her to be nothing but a tool.
Gerard's idea, not mine. They always viewed me with suspicion when I attempted any form of kindness towards her. That's why I created the data channel. A virtual place where we could speak in peace.
How do you know about Silence's plan?
He isn't the only one adept at spyware.
You hacked his focus?
No, he's too careful for that. But his subordinates? Not so much. He gave additional focuses to the tribals he branded the Sons of Prometheus. By tapping them, I learned about most of his dealings. The distribution of override technology, The arming of Tanakh rebels and the secret pact with Regala to attack Gerard's base.
But how did he come up with a weapon that can take down your shields?
That's the one thing I haven't been able to figure out, but however he did it, I'm quite certain it will work. With it and the Tanakh army, victory seems to be within his grasp. Such a shame he'll be disappointed.
First Varl. Now Hikaru and the Tanakh. Your plan would wipe out an entire tribe. There has to be another way.
We are in an admittedly desperate situation, but I assure you there isn't. Remember Zero Dawn. Elizabeth's sacrifice. Sometimes many have to die for a new world to grow.
If it looks impossible, look deeper. Wait. The data channel. It still exists, doesn't it? I need you to open it. Let me talk to Beta.
Impossible. We might be detected.
It's worth the risk. There is another way, one where the Tanakh survive.
But we won't. If the others...
If you want to help, open it. What are they doing to her?
Virtual reality dissociation. The manual merge of Hephaestus will take hours upon hours of tedious micromanagement. If she resists the work, they run simulations to induce feelings of isolation and despair.
Beta, can you hear me?
They're watching me. I can't hold up this extra protection for long. You should have killed me.
No. No, look at me. I'm coming for you. I promise. Okay? I just need you to hold out a little while longer and work on the merge. Contact again when it's time. Can you hold on?
As long as I know you're coming for me, I can endure anything.
All right. I did as you asked. Now I think you need to tell me what you're planning.
I'm going to take Sylon's army away. I don't need it. Only the weapon he made to penetrate your shields.
And how do you propose to get it? Ask him nicely?
Without Regala and her rebels, he won't have a choice. We'll be his only option.
Only option for what? What did you tell her?
That is between me and my sister. Will be Sylon's only option for crashing that base. I'll tell you the rest later. But first, there are a couple of things I have to do.
Oh. And what are those?
Lay my friend to rest. And then I'm going to use the override that Beta gave me at Gemini to put an end to Regala's rebellion. From the air.
Wait. since you insist on doing things your way, I know of something that will truly help you make a grand entrance with the Tenakt. The ancient Horus Titans still possess electromagnetic energy cells as part of their arsenal. Drop one of those on Regala's army and they'll receive quite a surprise. So go, do what you must. I'll come to your base if you manage to bring silence to the table.
Not if, when. Erend, are you there?
Aloy! Aloy, is that really you?
Yeah, it's me. Where's everyone else?
We're all... We're back at base. What happened?
It might be easier to explain in person. I'll try to join you there when I can.
Okay. We'll wait here for you. It's good to hear your voice, Aloy.
When you're wounded, you have to strike back. Draw blood.
Hey! Can I get one damn minute to mourn my friend?
Regala is going to slaughter my tribe to overthrow Hikaru. The Zeniths have Beta and Gaia. We can't sit around wallowing in our losses.
Katalo's right. We must fight.
Oh, all right. So what are we gonna do, huh? Take on all of Regala's rebels?
Not to mention the Zeniths. What can we even do? Throw ourselves at their base?
Something like that. So...
After we lost contact with you, we regrouped and went to Gemini. What happened? The recording we found on Varl's focus cut off when that Zenith, Eric...
The Zeniths were tracking Hephaestus. When Gaia trapped it in Gemini, they knew where we were. After Varl tried to stop them. They took Beta and Gaia. I only survived because one of the Zeniths turned against the others to save me.
One of them? Well... At least we didn't lose you too. So what do we do now?
We're going to defeat the Zeniths and get Beta and Gaia back. But first, we're going to stop Regala.
How?
Back in Gemini, Beta gave me a gift. There's something I need to do first to make it work, but it could put an end to the bloodshed.
Word is, Regala's readying her army for an all-out assault on the Grove. I need to be there.
I know. Go. Stand with Hikaru. And keep an eye on the sky.
Strike true as the Ten.
The rest of you, whatever preparations you need to make, upgrades, resupplies, get on it. It won't be long before we take the fight to the Zeniths.
We'll be ready, Aloy. And when you're ready, meet me outside the east exit. I'd like to have a word in private.
Even when things are darkest, you're the flame that lights the way forward.
Just tell me one thing. Am I gonna get to smash up a bunch of Zenith bastards?
We all are.
Good.
Before I do anything else, I should check on Zoe. It sounded important. There's the snow.
Over here, Aloy. We would come out here to tend to the garden. Sometimes I needed fresh air. Other times we would simply sit and watch the sunrise. So when we returned from Gemini, it seemed fitting that he be laid to rest here. Now he can always look out at plain song, and further east, to the Nora sacred lands.
He would have liked that.
He often spoke of his sister, Bala. He said she used to gather her favorite golden blooms and tie them to her spear. Their mother called it useless, but Bala was stubborn.
Yeah, she seemed like that.
It wasn't easy. But I tracked down the flower. Gathered its seeds.
As verdant limbs wither, roots rot in snow, still the sea rises as certain as stone.
From death follows new life. So it is with the land. And so it is with us. I'm with child, Aloy. I was going to tell him when he got back from Gemini. Instead, one day, I'll bring our child here. We'll sit among the blooms and watch the sunrise.
I never got to tell him. To thank him. For saving my life, sure, but also for not giving up on me.
He always knew.
I promise to look after them. I'll try to visit again when I can. But for now, I need to go to the fabrication terminal to install the new override on my spear. Then I'll use it on a sunwing and get ready for an entrance Regala will never forget.